Meteorologist Mark Molnar is your host for the weather show, Weather Northeastern. Let's get right into the particulars. A lot of you are probably wondering, are you going to have a white Christmas? Well, there's a lot of complication going on with the kick-in of a La Nina pattern that will be kicking in. Let's get right into the precipitation totals. A lot of this will be following as snow here from the Rocky Mountains into the Great Plains here and portions of the Northeast, especially a quick shot of snow to sleet to freezing rain, especially late Thursday night into Friday morning, heading on into portions of the area, New England, northern New England, Friday afternoon. After that, the warm air winds out. Let's take a look at that pattern. That pattern that will be kicking in just before Christmas and through Christmas Eve. Christmas Day, it takes a little bit of a tumble, but we will be seeing a ridge developing in the east here, pushing those systems to the north, pushing rain pretty far to the north, and warmer temperatures cutting way down on your white Christmas chances here. Back to the west, especially the plains, upper Midwest into portions of the Rocky Mountains, the Cascades, Sierra Nevada. This is where your snowfall forecast looks much more promising. Let's get right into those all-important snowfall totals here across the Northeast. Your eyes are pretty much drawn to this area from the I-90 corridor in upstate New York, portions of the Hudson Valley, and even the northern Susquehanna Valley of upstate New York into northeast Pennsylvania, the Poconos, the Catskills, the Adirondacks, the upper Hudson Valley, the White Mountains, the Berkshires here up into northern New England. This is where we could see a pretty good shot here. Binghamton on northeastward, even parts of Scranton on northeastward. Good solid 1 to 3 inches late Thursday night into Friday morning, and then extending 2 to 4 up to 3 to 6 inches here in the Mohawk Valley, portions of the upper Hudson Valley. And this, the warm air will ultimately win out here as snow goes to sleet, to freezing rain, and then to rain. But nevertheless, some bigger snowfall totals of 6 inches or more are likely across the Adirondacks, the maybe portions just north of Albany over towards portions of Vermont, New Hampshire, Maine, heading on into southern Quebec and southeastern Ontario here into portions of New Brunswick. So that is where things get really interesting here across the Northeast. It will be, like I said, a quick shot before much of the area will warm air will win out. So that will be something to talk about for Friday, but by Saturday, temperatures across the Northeast will be soaring. Let's get right into the particulars, starting off with your midpoint of the week, Wednesday. Look at this. Across much of the Northeast, we're not looking too bad. Of course, it could be a lot colder, but it could be a little bit warmer too. But most likely, this is the day we'll see most normal temperatures into the low to mid 30s, or for most of the Northeast here, where sun will try to break out across the area. This will be one of your few days where sunshine will break out. But then into your Thursday, we start to bring a front into the picture here, increasing cloudiness. The front will beginning to move out of the Tennessee and Ohio River valleys, starting to push to the northeast, and we'll start to see clouds increase, maybe even some wintry mix developing later in the day here. Portions of our western sections, temperatures slowly warming a little bit. But it will be Friday here. We'll start out as early morning hours, snow to sleet to freezing rain, and eventually to rain. As I said, from Binghamton to Scranton up to Syracuse, Rochester, we could see a quick 1 to 3 inches. Mohawk Valley, northern Hudson Valley, portions of the Catskills where the cold air holds on longer, 2 to 5 inches. And then portions of the Adirondacks up into portions of the White Berkshires Mountains into northern New England. That's where we could see the more of the 6 or more inches likely. As I said, the warm air will eventually win out here. And this sets the stage for your Saturday, where the cold front starts to move in from the west. Warm front pushes through the entire region just about, and temperatures soaring through the 50s and even some 60s here. Places like just east of Philadelphia could be hitting 70. So this is quite interesting, to say the least. This really puts a big dent and much of your white Christmas plans, except if you're into the upper areas of the Adirondacks, the Berkshires, the White Mountains, into northern New England, southern Ontario, and Quebec. But much of New York, Pennsylvania, and portions of New Jersey, southern New England, Ohio, southern Ontario, extreme southwestern Ontario here, your chances are really dimmed, to say the least. Now, we'll get a little colder after this, heading towards later Christmas Day and after Christmas Day. but we don't see, at this point, any major snowstorms. Here's my five-day outlook for my hometown viewers from Binghamton to Upper Susquehanna region. From Binghamton to Scranton's Upper Susquehanna region of upstate New York and northeast Pennsylvania. Take a look at this. This is where things get a little bit interesting. From your Wednesday, yes, we break out some sun into Thursday, increasing clouds, chance of maybe a late day sprinkle flurry, freezing drizzle. But this is Friday. Friday's an interesting day if you have to commute in the morning. Look at this. Snow to sleet to freezing rain, and then eventually to rain. So we'll stay about snow from about 6 a.m. all the way up to 10, maybe a 1 to 3 inch, over to sleet to freezing rain from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m., and then changing over to plain rain by 1 p.m. So we'll see about a tenth of an inch of ice to 1 to 3 inches of snowfall. And then over to rain, we stay rain wet Friday night into Saturday. Heavy rain, maybe a thunderstorm Saturday afternoon. Look at this, getting up into the low to mid 50s into your Sunday, Christmas Eve into Christmas Day. We cool it down a bit. We could see maybe a few snow showers, snowflakes on Christmas Day, but we're not looking at anything enough to get on the ground to create that white Christmas. And don't forget to like me on Facebook at MeteoMark, subscribe to me on YouTube at MeteoMark.com, it's Twitter at WX Northeastern, Google Plus at MeteoMark, it's MeteoMark.com, and WeatherNortheastern.com. That'll do it for this edition of Weather Northeastern.